Okay, the word is yours, so you can start.
Thank you. Good morning, everyone. I apologize that I'm not very present. There were some outstanding circumstances, but nevertheless, we found a way for me to share this experience with all of you. I don't know how many of you are there in the audience, hopefully a good number, so you can hear some of my personal experiences with the energy sector. So this topic is about reducing resistance, and I think this is a well-chosen title, because the energy sector is actually quite new in information security. It is just starting to learn and starting to be aware of that. Information security is part of their business, just as it is part of banking and e-commerce and sales and all other industries. So without ado, let's go into the problem directly. So let's describe the problem. First of all, let's talk briefly about the industry and the energy sector is. First of all, it's an industry of infinite demand. There is almost no stopping of the demand for energy. Everybody wants more energy for something else, whether it's for Bitcoin mining or for your new electrical cars or something else, there is demand for energy. Also, the same industry, whether the energy demands are infinite, is incumbent and almost legacy. It's been here for the past 50, 70, 100 years, even in some countries. So it's not something that is new, something that is quick. It has grown very slow for a very long time, and it has its own habits because of that. It has a very distributed infrastructure, as you very well know. Energy distribution, especially the distribution companies, are hugely distributed, either through an entire country or through regions of a country where they operate. But their infrastructure is physically distributed, access is difficult at some points, and failures are quite frequent and sometimes difficult to fix. Also, one of the major things, because this incumbent thing has been there for a very long time, technology has been there for a very long time, and it takes forever to change technology, simply because energy doesn't really change that much. Production and distribution of energy really hasn't, in essence, changed in the past, I don't know, maybe 100 years, not for Nikola Tesla. And finally, this is a strategic industry. For every country in the world, this industry is something that must continue to operate.